Good morning, everyone. I want to tell you about Dr. Sarvepalli Radhakrishnan. Dr. Sarvepalli Radhakrishnan was born 5th September in 1888 at Trutoni, Madras, in of poor Brahmin family. As his father was poor, Radhakrishnan supported most of his education through scholarship. Dr. Sarvepalli Radhakrishnan had his early education at Godi School, Truvellore, and then went to the Lutheran Missions Schools in Tirupati for his high school. He joined the various colleges in Vellore and later switched to the Madras Christian College. He chose philosophy as his major subject and did his BA and MA in it. After completing his MA, Sarvepalli Radhakrishnan accepted an assistant lecturership at the Madras Presidency College in 1909. In college, he mastered the classics of Hindu philosophy, namely the Upanishad, Bhagavad Gita, Brahma Sutra, and commentaries of Shankara, Ramanuj, and Madhav. In 1918, Dr. Sarvepalli Radhakrishnan was selected as professor of philosophy by the University of Mysore. In 1921, Radhakrishnan was nominated as professor of philosophy at the Calcutta University. In 1923, Dr. Sarvepalli Radhakrishnan's book, Indian Philosophy, was published. The book was hailed as a philosophical classic and a literary masterpiece. Sarvepalli Radhakrishnan was called to Oxford University to deliver lecture on Hindu philosophy. He used his lectures as a platform to further India's cause for freedom. He also argued that Western philosophers, despite all claims to objectivity, were blessed by theological influence from their wider culture. He showed that Indian philosophy, once translated into standard academic jargons, is worthy of being called philosophy by Western standards. He thus placed Indian philosophy on world map. In 1931, Dr. Sarvepalli Radhakrishnan was elected Vice Chancellor of the Andhra University. In 1939, Radhakrishnan became the Vice Chancellor of the Banaras Hindu University. In 1946, he was appointed as Ambassador to UNESCO. After independence, Dr. Radhakrishnan was requested to chaired the University Education Commission in 1948. The Radhakrishnan Committee's suggestions helped mold the education systems for India's needs. In 1949, Dr. Sarvepalli Radhakrishnan was appointed ambassador to the Soviet Union. He helped lead the foundation for a strong relationship with Soviet Union. Radhakrishnan was elected first vice president. Radhakrishnan was elected first vice president of India in 1952. He was honored with the Bharat Ratna in 1954. Origins of the Teachers' Day. Since 1962, 5th September has been celebrated as Teachers' Day in India. Dr. Sarvepalli Radhakrishnan was a philosopher and ideal teacher. He could be expanded, talented, educated, adorable, helpful, encouraging, responsible. He could be expanded, talented, educated, adorable, charming, helpful, encouraging, and responsible. He could be expanded, talented, expanded. He could be expanded, talented. He could be expanded, talented, educated, adorable, charming, helpful, encouraging, and responsible. Some of his students and friends opposed him and requested him to allow them to celebrate his birthday. In reply, Dr. Sarvepalli Radhakrishnan said, "Instead of celebrating my birthday separately, it would be my proud privilege if September 5th is observed as Teachers' Day." The requested show Dr. Radhakrishnan's love for the teaching's profession. From then onwards, his birthday is observed as Teachers' Day in India. That's it. Thank you.